don't do this often, but it feels like a nigga do it often. I wanna go to the...
Yo, what is up guys, welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys how to make that insane rainbow skin glow effect that you guys saw on the intro in Premiere Pro. Before I actually show you how to make that effect, you can join my Discord server, the link will be in the description. And in my Discord server, you can find all the links to download the plugins. And you can also just have some fun, just chat with other friends, you know, generally just have some fun. But yeah, let's just start the video. Alright, so after you put your clip to your timeline, you can just apply your velocity and then just sync your song with the kill and just do all that stuff. And if you don't know how to apply velocity, I've already made a tutorial on that. So just if you don't know how to do that, just watch that tutorial and then you can just apply your velocity. And after you've done that, just cut on the frame where you get the kill and also make sure to apply your impact. And then just cut on the frame where you pull out the shotgun. And then we can apply the presets. So first you're gonna select this part right here and you're gonna hold alt on your keyboard and drag that one layer above, which will create a duplicate of that clip. And then just go to effects control panel and just get the pen tool, and then you just wanna mask this skin out. And you will need to mask your skin frame by frame and also try to make the mask as perfect as you can, so the skin glow will look pretty, you know, it's look pretty good. And if you have After Effects, you can just do this pretty easily by right clicking and click on replace with After Effects composition, and it'll open up After Effects in your computer, and then just you can roto brush the skin out. You know, that's pretty simple to do, that's the same thing which I did. So after you mask the skin, just put it right here. Sorry, not that one. Okay, so after you mask the skin, just put it to the top track and then you can apply the presets. So just go to effects tab and then you're gonna right click on the presets bin, click on import presets, select the preset, click on open, and the preset should open up in your effects. And then just search for a rainbow buildup and the preset will pop up in your effects tab. And then go ahead and drag and drop the bottom track before next to this part right here, and you will see effect something like this. But for some reason, like the clip we are using is pretty different, so you won't get the exact same coloring like these things at the first time, so you can just you know, change these up. So all you want to do is you want to select the looks and make sure you have the newer version of Magic Blur looks. As I told you before, the link to download the new version of Magic Blur looks will be in my Discord server, so make sure to join that. And then just click on the looks and just click on edit look, and it'll open up the Magic Blur looks interface right here. And then I'm just gonna delete all these things real quick. So first you can just apply the HSL colors, and then also just apply a hue saturation, and then select the hue slash saturation and go ahead and change the hue to a fine, to a color that you want to highlight. So for me, I want to highlight this little part. And also make sure to select a color which is not everywhere on the frame. Like this is, I cannot highlight, so I'm just gonna highlight this color right here. So you can just change the hue and then go to your HSL colors. You can just delete that if that doesn't change anything, and then go to HSL colors, and you can just, so then just gonna decrease the colors that you don't want to highlight to -100 in saturation. So just decrease all that colors to -100, and then just simply increase the color that you want to highlight to +100, just like that. And then you just gonna click on the tools, and then you can just add a contrast, and then select the contrast, and then just increase the contrast like that. And also you can just increase this one, it'll make it a bit darker. And again, click on the tools, and then you can apply a S-curves. Just select that and just do that, you know, do all that, just make it like that. And after you've done that, you can just click on the tools again and add another hue saturation, and select that and just change the hue to until it did the color change to something like this. So the color will look pretty purplish. So just change the color until you find a color something like this, and then just click on the check mark. It'll look something like this. But if you don't like this thing, this effect, you can just search for BCC halftone and then just put it to the bottom track and then just simply just change the brightness to 13 or something like that. Or we can just increase it, maybe just make it something like this without, and then you can just delete all the effects, but you can just leave the BCC halftone and you'll be done. But for me, I just like to keep it like this, and then again open up the preset and then put the character preset to this top track, and you will get this color. So as you guys can see, when the color of the character is changing, also the background color is also changing with that color, you know, like it's blend with that, you know. Hope that makes sense. And yeah, after you done that, you can just select these two clips, right click and it's the clip, click OK, and then just search for S underscore blur mock ups and put it to this part right here, and go to the beginning and you're gonna keyframe the Z dist and go to the like the middle somewhere right here, and keyframe it again and go to the end and go one frame back, keyframe it again and go to the middle keyframe right here, and you can just change the Z dist to 0.65 or something like that, and select this keyframe. So just shift click on these keyframes, right click and make them a continuous bezier, and just click this little arrow thing and then select this and just pull this handle to your right side while holding shift, and also just pull this to your right side just like that, so it'll go slow and at the end you know, like it'll be fast. So just play this. Okay, that looks pretty good. If not, you can just do like that. Okay, I think that looks good. After that, you can just apply your impact and you'll be done, and then just play this and you'll get this effect. And yeah guys, that's pretty much it for the video, and thank you so much for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe the channel, it'll really means the world to me. So yeah, also you can join my Discord server, and yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys on my next video. Peace.